Mermaid. I nobody requested this. This is my own request essentially because I wanted to be able to post it under that mermaid tag on Twitter. And they're in the Master Manual, so I might as well kill two sailors with one fish lady. So here's what we've got. And let me first show you how the drawing went. So I always start with my circles. The hair looks a little weird because I was doing a. I'll play that again. Wow, that was slow. That was fast. The hair looks a little weird because I had to do the front layer and back layer and then put them back, stack them differently. But they make sense when they're stacked, which I guess is the main thing. Oh, you want me to do a merman? Well, for now, you're gonna have to put up with her because she's what I drew. All right, let's see. So, as always, I need. Oh, good. I have finally modified this so that my default file has the brush strokes in it, which is what I want. So, but what I don't have is my fancy dancy Pixelscapes thing that I like to use. Let me go get it. There's always something working. Template. Because I like my Pixelscapes with the gradient. Duplicate layer to the mermaid. All right. And then I can get rid of this purple Pixelscapes because that's not intense enough for me. Okay, and I'm gonna put this. I'll throw it down here just for now. All right, so I guess I might as well start with our body here. What colors do you think? Well, I know I want a gradient from head to toe. I do kind of like this blue. I kind of like the colors I've got here. Maybe I'll do like a purple to pink gray. Well, I just can't decide. What colors have I used recently? And then I can use some other colors. Let me take a look. I'm checking. I am checking. Oh, I was doing the slots. Well, that doesn't help. Oh, I drew Dracula. He was very purple and red. So maybe if I do like magenta and blue, then that'll work. So that is what I'm gonna do. Let's see. Yeah, she has a lot of HPG pointed out she's very outside the ring. If I activate my no-fly zone, you can see that she's still inside my designated area. So I cut it close, but yeah, because she had, you know, her hair and her tail and everything, I had more parts to stick out. But yeah, sometimes it's just like one or two things at the top and maybe a tail at the bottom. So I love those sticky outy bits almost as much as I like gradients. So that's saying something. Ooh, that's an interesting idea. HPG suggested having her tail wrap around the inner ring. Oh. Like it could go under the ring and then back around. I like that a lot. I like that a lot. I'm totally gonna do that. Let's do that thing. Yeah. I like it. So I'm gonna. Yeah, the upper part will go under. Exactly. Let me make a selector for that. And then I'm going to load selection, the ring's transparency and add it to the, okay, there you go. So, whoop. I don't know if you can see my little marching ants here, but, and then I'm going to select modify contract by 2 because I want to make sure that it really overlaps. And then, that's what I'm going to go for. Yes, HPG, I actually had a very good day, and I am happy about that. For sure. All right, so I'm going to erase the lines, which apparently didn't vanish. That's odd. Where are the lines? Oh, they're on here too. Okay. Well, then I will erase them off there too. There we go. Yeah, look at that. I like it. And you know, I could have one of her pieces of hair do that too. Like maybe the bottommost one. I could try that. Yeah, let's try that one. What a cool suggestion. Thank you, HPG. I've always sort of thought of this as a, the ring as like the edge of a can. And so sometimes they're inside the can and sometimes they're coming out. But thinking of the ring as a literal ring like this is also very cool. So that's neat. I'm definitely going to incorporate this more in the future. Canned tuna. Yes, exactly. That's, it's truly tragic, isn't it? It's a sad thing. Let's see. I think I wanna. I wanna move her hand a little. You see how her thumb is overlapping the edge and sort of fades out to nothing? That annoys me. So I'm gonna change it. Filter. Oh, I can't liquify group. Bastards. Okay. Filter. Liquify. She's naked. OMG naked. Alright, let's get a more reasonably sized hand mover thingy in here. And it's still inside the no-fly zone. So that's perfect. Yeah, that's a little better. I like that much better. Okay. So. I'm gonna get her body here and her ear. Oh, I forgot the rest of her tail because now it's separate. Okay, let's get that too. Skin color. So, you know what? Putting pink on her when she's female is like super stereotypical. So I'm gonna make her definitely just blue and purple. So let's get my purple. Yeah. If I use any pink, I'll just use it for contouring, I guess. Oh, I don't know. Let me change this and think about it. And I don't want to make her orange again because that's a little too Simpsons. I can make her. HPG asks if I was thinking of doing the color shift thing I did with the other underwater one, with the aboleth. Yeah, I thought about it, but I think I decided not to add a waterline to this one. I'm still gonna do some color shift in the lines like I did on the aboleth because that's an effect I've really been enjoying lately. But for now, here's where I'm at. I also thought about adding some bubbles, which I'm perfectly comfortable adding stereotypically, even for fish, even though they don't breathe water. But I decided this was busy enough visually, so I ended up not doing it. So, okay. Filter. Select. Load selection. That's the transparency for that. So I'm gonna now do a gradient to empty. And I'm gonna do it like this. No, that's totally useless. I'm gonna have to use a brush. So let me get a big brush. And that is not nearly different enough. Okay, let me try it with erasing instead. Whoa. And the brush not being that hard. Yeah, that's a little better. That is not 100% opaque. That's interesting. I will have to correct that. Oh, I see. Well, that's okay. That's okay. Tail color. Tail color. All right. And then. I really want it more gradual. Like, I don't want to have just a waistline. No, not that. This side. Yeah. And then I could have another shade of tail. Back further. And then do one more shade. Which is green, which I'm gonna heavily erase. So it's just the end of her tail. Kinda like that. Yeah, that way it's kinda like under lighting, you know? Yeah, I want to do a scale effect also. I just haven't decided yet. So let's see. Yeah, I like that. And then she needs some highlighting on her skin. Select, load selection, skin transparency. On her humanish skin, that is. Oh, look at that. There's actually some blue on her hand. Let me zoom in a little more here. Yeah, I didn't erase that real well. Well, there's something we can do about that, which is to paint it. Huh. Okay, so it's not the blue. Oh, I see. All right, let's try something else then. It's on all these. No. It's actually on all these layers, and so it's like the accumulated. So I've got to get it off of all the layers that I made. Okay. Much better. Jeez. All right. Now I can do my selection and then make the skin lights. Can I make them blue? Because I don't want to go pink. Think I'm gonna do that. Blue is good. Like that same blue, actually. All right. I had kind of underlighting on her tail. Maybe I should do that here too. Yeah, something like that. Oh, darn it. I put it on a layer copy. Well, oh well. That's fine. There's only so many layers I really need, technically. New. All right, let's try this again. Let's try this again with the right color. Let's try this again with the other right color. Sure, I'm fussy. Fussy about cleavage. Okay. And that's our body for now. I'm gonna add a scale effect. I think you're right, but not right now. Skin unified. All right, let me get her hair. Now, her hair is in two different places because there's a front and a back. So I gotta treat them both the same. So I'm gonna take her skin away and the lines because otherwise it's gonna get, and her tail lines. Because otherwise it's gonna get even weirder than this already looks. gotta hide my Pixelscapes for a minute. I'm gonna try my crazy filters to make her hair like weirdly shiny. I think that that could be fun. Or I could make her hair weirdly iridescent. Oh, that's pretty awesome. That's pretty awesome. All pretty awesome, dude. Let's try the rainbow paint just to see how ridiculous it'll be. Well, it's pretty ridiculous. That's nicely ridiculous. Let me change the radius. And then for the surface, I'm gonna change the texture to something more hairy, maybe. Do I have something more hairy? Streaks? Streaky noise? Ah! That's not very fun. Scales. Maybe I'll use the water. The water's subtle and kind of appropriate. Kind of makes her hair look like dreads. I think it really do need some kind of grain. I might go back to what we had. Or I could just make no texture. Just have it be weirdly smooth. I like breaking it up a little. Okay. Refractive? I wonder what that does. Nothing in this case. Reflective? New! I want the reflective, clearly. I want less sheen, though, maybe. Yeah, because I don't want that white highlight. Because we're underwater. Nah, I really don't want it. It's always fun to see how little any of these make a difference. Okay. I'm gonna use this. And it's gonna take a while to calculate, so I'll bring you back to the actual hair. I mean, I could use the iridescence on her. I could do an iridescent pattern on her body, like scales. That could be good. Well, that's certainly radioactive. Let's see how it looks with the rest of it. Oh. Yeah, I did something dumb. Okay. It's a mermaid. Hello. But I need to fix it. Let's see. Yeah, that looks pretty awesome. And I like the blue outline. I might just leave that. I mean, I'll probably put some, some color on that fin. Yeah, that works. Okay. Hi, welcome to the chat. And yeah, I had her face covered up with her hair. So when I cleared that out, it changed everything. All right, select, reselect. All right. So let's see. That's the iridescent hair. In the front. And then this is the hair iridescent back. Which I'm thinking of shifting. I'm actually thinking of shading it a little. Let's try that. I'm not sure that really helps. I kind of like the it all being the same and a little visually confusing. Maybe I'll just change the shade a little. Oh, that's too pink though. Make it greener. All right. I've messed around with that enough. I think she needs her tail done. Since her body has black lines, I'm going to do the same thing to her fins as like a gradient, like this, except I will make it more opaque. Whoops. Because I do need it to kind of stand out from her bottom there a little. All right. And then the fin color. Let's try that. Asking if I like the idea of Magic the Gathering playmats. I mean, there's a lot of possibilities in the world. I'm gonna have to pick and choose if I'm gonna be setting up a whole store. I gotta find a place that can do fulfillment. Hopefully print on demand. I don't know that there's a print on demand place that will handle all that for me for Magic the Gathering playmats. But you know, we'll see. We'll see what I come up with. I think I'm gonna do the prints myself and get somebody else to do t-shirts, like one of the online services. And then beyond that, buttons, I do have a button maker, but I'm not sure how many people are gonna want. So I don't know. So at least I could do those three things, I imagine. Yeah, that fin looks hella awesome because it's iridescent. That is really pretty. Let me try changing the hue and see if I like that more, like a green. Or going through like an extension of the, gosh, so many options. I just can't decide. I think I should stick with the colors of the mermaid though, like this. And because I am a horrible person, well, not super horrible, but I am gonna have to fade this. No, not with black, thank you. I'm gonna use an eraser. Because I want to have some transparency. That's part of the fun, after all. But I can do it in a way that so that it doesn't all get taken away. Feather 40, maybe? Yeah, this way. It will, whoop, no, not that, not that. My color. That way it keeps some of it opaque while the rest of it fades. But I think I might have gone a little too, oh no, that's not how, I meant to do it the other way. Let me select inverse and then try that. Yeah, that way the highlight stays pretty solid, but you can still see the stuff in the background. So now I have to figure out my colors. No, I've got her. I gotta figure out my, There's a lot of stuff to figure out. Fin. I gotta get my, let me figure out my background colors, 'cause I'm gonna end up, I gotta make sure that that works with the transparent fin. Inner color. Well, these are all cool. Maybe I'll go. No, why didn't that work? Okay, that's very weird. So I see it, but not. That was blocking it. Select, deselect. Not the hair, not the skin. That's just more hair. A fin? No. What the hell? Oh, it's because this layer doesn't show. Ha ha. Derp. Okay. I'm kind of silly that way. Okay. Let's try. sunset. Because see, if I go too far, then I'd have a pink, which is too monochrome. And if I go too far this way, but then that green doesn't pop. Ugh. Let me try something. I'm gonna make the rest of it the color I want and then change what's behind the fin. Yeah, like that. Cause if I don't, it will, if I don't, it'll make that brown. Yeah, that's probably a little better. Because then it makes the hair stand out a little more. And adds more green. All right. And then the outer ring. Which of course will look marvelously twirly for 3D, thanks to HPG's suggestion. Yes, I like how the fin is translucent also. That is something I go for whenever I have fins. I wanted it to be solid enough that you could see the iridescence, but still be what it is. So let's see. All right. Got red there. Well, I guess I'll just do another gradient and then experiment with it. Too green. Ooh, dreaded pink. Oh, the pink looks good there, no. Okay, forget it. Let me try the other direction. I mean, the green is okay. Maybe it blends too much. Huh. I gotta decide what I'm doing. I'm gonna try it with iridescence, since I've been going crazy anyway. I like the blue around her eyes. Like, makes her look a little haunted. Or, hey, I didn't put the little highlight dots in her eyes. I'll have to do that manually. I knew I forgot something. That's pretty neat. But it's probably too much like the hair. Let me switch it around to something else. That's too much like the tail. Meh. Well, while I think about that, I'm going to add some shading shadow to her hair. But just where it overlaps the ring. And then her front hair. Also needs this hair front shadow. Can you tell I'm picky? These would be so much faster if I wasn't so picky. Okay. Oh, and her hair around her face is a little dark. Just adds a little contrast. And then that should help me figure out what to do with this ring, because then it's not going to blend straight into the hair. Maybe I'll go with yellow. It's not very watery, but her colors are so cool. I like the rest of it not being. Oh, let's see. So I was gonna grab my brush strokes. Selection. Brush strokes. And then use that just to add something to this ring here. Yeah, just so it has some variety, and then I'll do the same thing with the background, and then as for her bod here. You know, I like it being a little more painty, but let me make a separate copy in case I change my mind later. But I'm also going to add scales. So, I can't do literal scales that like follow the S curve. Not unless I want to spend a whole lot of time drawing, and I really don't. Let me see if I can find just an image that I can use as a filter. Because maybe I can do it and just go crazy. Okay. I don't know if this is going to work, but I can try. that'll probably work. Whether I can get it to work here, of course, is anybody's bet. So let's see. I mean, it's passable. And then I need another one for the other end of the tail. All right. I'm not sure if you guys can even see what I'm doing on the stream, but it'll work. I'm pretty sure it'll work. So there's my three scale layers. And what I'm going to do is pull that all the way to the front. And, whoops. I clearly should not have merged those layers. There's an extra piece that I need to get rid of right here. Alright, now I'm going to merge them. Okay. And behind them, I'm going to put black. So, you see how it's, mostly got the right idea. Then what I can do is make them brighter. Then use a channel to select them. And then I'm going to do a couple things. One, I'm gonna edit, fill, black. Okay. And then, oh, and I'm gonna leave it selected. Select, view, extras. So now on this copy of the skin, I'm gonna use these as a hue filter. Yeah, there we go. So she now has scales. And then these black scales. Nah, that looks pretty crappy. I'm gonna save these scales because they could very well be a handy thing for the future. Let's see. So she has scales. It's not going to show at most sizes, but hey, whatever works, right? And then, I don't know, she might be done. I guess I could put scales on her arms, but I've spent a lot of time on her already. Yeah, I like her. I think she's good. In a larger print, it'll show. But you notice as I color shift her, the scales will get more and less obvious. Like you're not even gonna see it when she's green. Okay. Actually, I deleted that layer. I shouldn't have deleted it. I can actually bump up these scales a little more even. Why does it do that? I guess it's good. I'm waffling. Maybe that's better. But I'm not going to let it overlap the lines. Let me get the lines. Okay. And I think that works a little better. And then I wanted to color some lines. Let's see. Here's where I'm going to use a little pink. Because I'm going to fade it back. And then it'll look more like purple. Except that I messed that up. Darn it. Okay. Let's try this again. Okay, and then I'm gonna make that like that much. Okay. And then do I want to put some color on the rings? Since I've also been enjoying that lately. I've been working on this for way too long. But that's okay. I'm having fun. Let's see. Probably some blue. Like real dark blue. Yeah, I like that. Where her tail goes around it, there's like a bunch of different colors. It's fun. Oh, and her eyes. I still haven't done her eyes. For Pete's sake, Jen. Just eyes. Okay. Now, I like the sort of garnet color actually. Ooh. There's a edge around her hair here that I am not a big fan of. What's going on there? Oh, I see. Maybe it's on her bottom hair. That's the problem with having so many lines.
That should take care of it. That was strange.
But when in doubt, just hide it.
I don't know what was going on there. But it's dead now. Okay. What was I gonna do? I already forgot. Oh, her eyes. Yeah. It's a little too big. Alright, here she is. I think she's finally done. And then here's what she looks like in the black background. That's where the line colors really pop, which I love. Alright. Okay. So, alright. I am going to save it. For God's sake, save it. Thank you all for watching this one. Let's see what time it is. I can definitely do at least one more. That's probably going to be Fairy Dragon. So I'm going to shut this down and then restart the broadcast in like a couple minutes. I got to wash my contact lens. So thank you very much, and I will see you shortly. Yay!